Hi, I'm Chris Ferguson of the STS-135 crew, and you're watching NASA TV.
All three engines up and burning. 2, 1, 0, and liftoff. The final liftoff of Atlantis. Shoulders of the space shuttle. America will continue the dream. From Launch Complex 39 at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, this is Shuttle Launch Control at T-minus 3 hours and holding. And we're now in the final 5 hours of the countdown for the launch of the last flight of the Space Shuttle program and Space Shuttle Atlantis on STS-135. Here's our commander, Chris Ferguson. He's in the suit-up room. He's having a fit check of his helmet. Pilot Doug Hurley. This is his second trip into space. And here is Mission Specialist number 1, Sandy Magnus. This is Rex Walheim. He's our Mission Specialist number 2. And here they come. Crew going down the elevator where they'll be greeted by employees from Kennedy Space Center and members of the news media. This is the same elevator that's been used by the astronauts ever since Apollo. Flight crew is now in the white room of the orbiter access arm. Members of the closeout crew are in the white coveralls, and the astronauts, of course, are in the orange pressure suits. The closeout crew will be assisting the astronauts with their helmets and other equipment as they enter the orbiter.
See, out in the white room, that's Chris Minert again, number 5. You got Travis, number 1, and they're just getting Rex in. So hopefully, if things go well today, this will be the last astronaut you'll see climbing into a vehicle to go fly in space on the shuttle.
And attention all personnel, this is the NTD conducting the launch status check. Verify ready to resume count and go for launch. OTC.
OTC is go.
TBC.
Tank and booster go.
PTC.
PTC is go.
LPS.
LPS is go.
Houston flight.
Houston flight, if you pull me at the end, I would appreciate it. Stand by.
Yes, sir, we'll pull you later. Mila.
Mila is go.
STM.
STM is go.
Safety console.
Safety console is go.
SBE.
SP is go.
LRD.
LRD is go.
SRO.
SRO is go. You have a range clear to launch.
And CDR.
CDR is go.
And Launch Director NTD, our launch team is ready to proceed with the exception of Flight, who still needs a little bit more time to make his evaluations on RTLS weather.
I copy that. I'll do my poll at this time. KC Chief Processing Engineer, verify no constraints to launch.
No constraints.
Thank you, Steve. KC Safety Mission Assurance.
Safety and mission assurance is still, Mike.
Thank you, Terry. Payload launch manager.
Hey, Mike, on behalf of the ISS ground processing team, I want to say thanks to you and the shuttle team. It's been a great partnership, and we are go.
Thank you, Bill. Appreciate that. Range weather.
Launch weather has no constraints for launch.
Thank you, Kathy. Atlantis Flow Director.
On behalf of the KSC Civil Processing Team, we are go.
Thank you, Angie. Ops Manager.
See, Mike, wait to get the final go from flight here. Let's hear what he says, and we'll get back to you.
Copy that. Atlantis Launch Director, Air to Ground 1.
Atlantis, go.
Okay, Fergie, we're starting to feel pretty good down here on the ground about this one today. So on behalf of the greatest team in the world, good luck to you and your crew on the final flight of this true American icon. And so for the final time, Fergie, Doug, Sandy, and Rex, good luck, Godspeed, and have a little fun up there.
Hey, thanks to you and your team, Mike. Until the very end, you all made it look easy. The shuttle's always going to be a reflection of what a great nation can do when it dares to be bold and commits to follow through. We're not ending the journey today, Mike. We're completing a chapter of a journey that will never end. You and the thousands of men and women who gave their hearts, souls, and their lives for the cause of exploration have rewritten history. Let's light this fire one more time, Mike, and witness this great nation at its best. The crew of Atlantis is ready for launch.
Thank you, sir. We'll get you going here in a couple of minutes.
NTD, Houston flight on 212.
Go ahead, flight.
For the record, I'm go.
NTD copies, and launch director, that is our entire launch team. We are ready to proceed at this time.
I copy that. NTD with that, you are clear to launch Atlantis.
I copy that, sir. Thank you.
The countdown clock will resume on my mark. 3, 2, 1, mark.
T-minus 9 minutes and counting.
DLS other sequence has been initiated. DLS is go for orbital access arm recheck.
Atlantis, this is OTC. This day has been over 30 years in the making. There have been many fabulous missions throughout the years. On behalf of KSC launch teams past and present, we salute the entire astronaut corps for their dedication, not only for our expanded knowledge of the universe, but for the improvement you have contributed to on Earth. Have an excellent mission and Godspeed.
Fantastic words, Roberta. Thank you very much. Great to your team. Thank you, sir.
PLT OTC, perform APU start.
And on.
CDR OTC, reconfigure heater.
That's in work.
Flight crew OTC, close and lock your visors and initiate O2 flow.
That's in work.
T-minus 2 minutes.
DLS is go for ET LH2 pressurization.
T-minus 40 seconds, handing off to Atlantis' computers at T-minus 31. T-minus 35, 33.
Clock will hold at T-minus 31 seconds due to a failure.
And we have had a failure. Ground lock sequencer.
We had a problem on the box recheck switches. NTDSC,
go ahead.
Yes, sir, we need guys to go do the verification for the LCC, please.
All right, CMAC.
Yes, CMAC, the LCC says we need to verify using a camera, and we're positioning camera 62 right now.
Okay, let us know as soon as 62 is swung over and you can verify LCC for GVA retract, please.
This is CMAC, we verify retracted.
All right, and SPE?
And NTD, SPE concurs, they satisfy the requirements of GSC 13 pre-plan contingency, I'm go.
Okay, I copy, and launch director.
Yes, sir, I heard all that and concur. Press on.
And GLS, you can resume the clock on your mark.
I copy that. Countdown clock will resume on my mark. 3, 2, 1, mark.
T-minus.
Go for auto sequence start.
Hand off to Atlantis' computers has occurred. Solid rocket booster nozzle steering check in work.
20.
Firing chain is armed.
15.
Go for main engine start. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. All three engines up and burning. 2, 1, 0, and liftoff, the final liftoff of Atlantis on the shoulders of the space shuttle. America will continue the dream.
Control ground, Houston. Roger, roll, Atlantis.
Houston now controlling the flight of Atlantis. The space shuttle spreads its wings one final time for the start of a sentimental journey into history. 24 seconds into the flight, roll program complete. Atlantis now heads down, wings level on the proper alignment for its 8.5-minute ride to orbit. 4.5 million pounds of hardware and humans taking aim on the International Space Station. 40 seconds into the flight, the three liquid fuel main engines throttling back to 72% of rated performance in the bucket, reducing stress on the shuttle as it goes transonic for the final time. Engines now revving up, standing by for the throttle up call.
Atlantis, go at throttle up, no action, DPDT.
Go with throttle up, no action on DPDT.
That call from Capcom Barry Wilmore, a transducer, instrumentation only, no action required. Atlantis now 15 miles in altitude, already 16 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 1 minute 40 seconds into the flight. Atlantis flexing its muscles one final time. Atlantis traveling almost 2,600 miles an hour, 21 miles in altitude, 24 miles downrange, standing by for solid rocket booster separation. Booster officer confirms staging a good solid rocket booster separation. Guidance now converging. The main engine steering the shuttle on a pinpoint path to its preliminary orbit. 2 minutes, 20 seconds into the flight, Atlantis already traveling 3,200 miles an hour, 35 miles in altitude, 50 miles downrange. Standing by for main engine cutoff. Booster officer confirms main engine cutoff. For the last time, the space shuttle's main engines have fallen silent as the shuttle slips into the final chapter of a storied 30-year adventure. Now standing by for external tank separation.
Words can't express the pride that I have in all of you and the gratitude that I have for the job that you do. This is the most outstanding group of professionals, the most dedicated launch team of technicians and engineers anywhere in the world. And the United States owes you a deep debt of thanks. And I want to thank you for your service to our country. Thank you for your service to NASA and the Kennedy Space Center, to the shuttle program, and most of all, thank you for this outstanding ride that we have had for the last 30 years aboard a United States space shuttle. You guys are absolutely the best. Thank you.
Marshall Space Flight Center, thanks for that great message and awesome ride to orbit, and 134 before that.
Atlantis Houston, good config for the burn.
Copy, good config.
Flying high over the Atlantic Ocean off the west coast of Africa, we're just seconds away from this course correction burn. As we watch over the shoulders of Chris Ferguson and Doug Hurley up on the flight deck of Atlantis.
You could see very clearly the cannon-like jolt of those big orbital maneuvering system engines. And courtesy of space station cameras, our first view of the shuttle Atlantis.
Goodburn Atlantis, no trim required.
Copy, Goodburn.
Through the centerline camera in the orbiter docking system, this sequential still video view of the International Space Station.
Atlantis Station on the big loop, we have you in sight.
Excellent, we'll be there soon.
We're waiting.
Atlantis Houston, you are go for the RPM. Go to proceed inside 600 feet.
Houston Station, Atlantis on the big loop, initiating RPM in 3, 2, 1, mark. We copy.
Houston copies.
With that, Commander Chris Ferguson now will begin the slow 3/4 of a degree per second rotational backflip. This again is about a 9-minute maneuver. You'll hear the start photography call initiated when the orbiter is in the correct orientation of this procedure. The actual R-bar pitch maneuver will last about 9 minutes in duration, about 93 seconds of available photography for Sergei Volkov, Mike Fossum, and Satoshi Furukawa.
Station Atlantis on the big loop. Start photos. Start your photos.
And with that, a period of about 93 seconds of good photography now initiated for Sergei Volkov, Mike Fossum, and Satoshi Furukawa using digital cameras and high-powered lenses out of the Zvezda service module. The rendezvous officer indicates to Flight Director Quatziella Barujo that Commander Chris Ferguson has flown a textbook R-bar pitch maneuver. And you can see the structure of the International Space Station now coming into view as both spacecraft pass over the limb of the Earth. Atlantis coming up on the so-called V-bar, the velocity vector.
Atlantis Houston on the big loop. The teams have been pulled. In concurrence, you are go for docking.
Atlantis on the big loop, copies, go for docking. Houston and station Atlantis on the big loop, we don't see a flyout. We're initiating final approach.
Houston copies.
Station copies.
Pilot Doug Hurley informing both station and shuttle flight control rooms that no flyout is required, meaning no additional alignment required. Commander Chris Ferguson is dead spot on with the two docking mechanisms perfectly aligned. Contact, docking confirmed. Capture confirmed at 10:07 a.m. Central Time.
Houston, station Atlantis, capture confirmed, and we see free drift.
Station Atlantis Houston, station free drift is confirmed.
Atlantis arriving. Welcome to the International Space Station for the last time. That's great to be here, station. We'll see you shortly.
It's good to be home on station. How's everybody?
Come on, Jim. Come on, Jim.
All right.
Come on, Jim. Push off.
Big Russian hug.
Come on, Jim. Push off.
Big Russian hug. How you doing, guys?
Good to see you.
Hey, Doug.
Chuckster.
What's the game, Morse?
Hello.
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 Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Finally meeting on board the ISS.
Yes.
In the wake of yesterday's docking of Atlantis to the International Space Station, the heavy lifting begins, the highlight of which will be the unberthing and removal of the Raffaello multipurpose logistics module from the cargo bay of Atlantis. Raffaello is 21.6 feet long, 15 feet wide. Fully loaded, weighs about 12 and a half tons. It is equipped and supplied by 9,403 pounds of cargo. that will be transferred to the International Space Station over the course of the next several days.
And Houston, Atlantis, we're starting the maneuver to unberth the MPLM.
We copy, Sandy. We're following.
And with Kid Gloves, Sandy Magnus, at the controls of the station's robotic arm, beginning the process of unberthing Raffaello from Atlantis's cargo bay.
And Atlantis, the MPLM is unberthed. I don't know if you want to mess with the keel camera at all just to see if it's working, but if you manage to get it on, you can deactivate it.
Okay, we'll take care of that. Thanks.
Yeah, on the big loop, Sandy and Satoshi, maneuver to RTL complete. Your go for first stage capture.
Hey, Houston on the big loop. We're going to pick up at 1.108. Step one, we're ready to open the NO2 Nader hatch.
Ferg, we copy and we're good with that.
Hey, Rob, are you guys up on the Columbus camera here pointing down into the Nader NO2?
Affirmative.
Okay, so for all you guys who worked Expedition 18, I'd like to announce the return of the Sox.
We got a great view. Thanks.
Just a little nostalgia there for a moment.
We appreciate it.
STS-135 pilot Doug Hurley there, along with Sandy Magnus, moving a fairly large-size heat exchanger through the station. There's quite a bit of equipment being moved from the MPLM into the station, but also quite a bit being moved from the station back into the MPLM, as well as Atlantis's mid-deck. So the crew is well underway getting all of these materials and supplies transferred from one carrier to another.
This is Mission Control Houston. Spacewalk preparations continue in the equipment lock section of the Quest airlock. You see Mike Fossum slithering his way into the upper torso of his extravehicular mobility unit. Not the easiest task in the world, but with the assistance of Satoshi Furukawa on the left and Atlantis Commander Chris Ferguson on the right, Fossum is now secured in the upper torso portion of a suit, flexing his arms to make sure he's comfortable. And a good view from another camera in the Quest airlock as you watch Fossum on the right and Garen on the left flexing their legs, part of this exercise pre-breathe protocol.
Yeah, all the checks look good. Are you guys ready?
81, born ready. Mike was always born ready.
Okay, the thermal catch cover is open. You can egress the airlock if you want.
All right.
Be attaching an anchor hook to the aft external D-ring.
Ready, you ready to rock and roll? Ready to rock and roll. Let's go, buddy. Time to get to work.
We started out installing the new COLT tools, or the Contingency Operation LAPA tools, onto the backside of the pump module platform. Those went right into position. What a great team working together to get that designed. Those tools worked flawlessly. Pump module hung up just a little bit on the external stowage platform before we got it released. He gave it one more little try with the PGT. Bolt didn't turn at all, so he gave it a little yank, and the whole thing came loose. And there you can see it starting to move.
Nice job, guys.
Nice and easy. I'm clear of the course.
Hey, Rex, thanks a lot. Appreciate that.
It's about 1,500 pounds, so it takes quite a bit to move it.
Okay, Ronnie, you ready to lift up the pump module? Let's do it. It's 1,400 pounds, buddy. Let's do this. Yeah, okay. Ready?
Here you see Ron controlling the whole thing on the robot arm, and notice he's just very slowly turning the whole thing over. It started out in one orientation, kind of a heads-up orientation, and he needed to turn it 180 degrees around so that when he got down to the payload bay, he'd be heads down in the payload bay and could install the pump module when he got down there.
Now clear of external stowage platform number 2, headed down to Atlantis's payload bay, where the pump module will be secured on a truss support structure at the very back of the bay for the trip back home and an engineering evaluation to determine what caused the pump to fail on the night of July 31st last year. There are three spare pump modules residing on various locations on the International Space Station for use in the future should another one go down.
Nice looking spaceship you guys got here.
Why, thank you.
Mike Fossum is preparing the work site at the Mission Peculiar Support Structure, as it's called, the cargo truss, basically, at the back of the cargo bay of Atlantis. Just above him is Ron Guerin holding on to the pump module and its support attachment mechanism.
Okay, Ron.
The pump module and its attachment mechanism now aligned to a comparable attachment mechanism on this truss at the rear of Atlantis's cargo bay.
You guys are good with the GCA. We can end GCA and go break down.
GCA is complete.
Okay. Brakes are on. You guys are clear for APFR egress and ingress.
Mike Fossum has this robotic refueling mission, the RRM, in his hands. He's on the end of the station's arm and moving out of Atlantis' payload bay.
Hey, close encounter to OPSS.
You bet.
Cheerful red light on the top.
Here you see the robotics refueling mission just about to be installed and handed off to the Dexter arm over on the lab nadir. I know that everybody at Goddard was holding their breath. They were making sure that we were all sending them good wishes, and we were able to get it installed onto the Dexter just fine. Then it was off to install the MISSI, or the Materials ISS experiment, the small portion of that called the ORMATE. Took some photos of that. That's material samples that are exposed to the RAM and wake of space. From there, we went on to work on the grapple fixture that had the little wire sticking out through one of the latch doors. You can see it getting cleared there and then pulled out of the way. That went just like the training. It was just like watching training video to see how well this went, just like we had planned. It doesn't always go that well, but today it sure did, and we were glad to see it. Our final task on the EVA was installing the thermal cover. Here you see it coming out of the bag. You can think of it as a great big comforter coming out of the on-orbit replacement ORU bag. Here you can see it in its final configuration, strapped down. It's got nine Velcro straps that hold it into position. And about the time that they had it installed in this configuration, the thermal officer in the front room in the Mission Control Center stood up and turned around and said, "I can already see it starting to take effect." He could already see it in his data just that fast. So that's a very successful project.
Well, I'd like to thank there were a lot of teams whose hard work all came into play for this EVA. Linda Brown led a magnificent team of people that put together a lot of stuff, and they had to do it in the hard way with Ron and I, with Ron and me traveling a lot. And not even in country at the same time together a lot. They had to work really hard and had a really, really well integrated plan put together with all of the products and the pieces that really came together. And from Goddard, the Colt team, the pump module team to figure out how to get that thing back. A whole lot of work by a lot of teams around the country, really. But really all came together today, and that's what made the difference. Hatch is closed.
Oh, I'm a rocket man. Rocket man. I'm running out of shoes. I'm alone.
Good morning, Atlantis. This is Elton John. We wish you much success on your mission, and a huge thank you to all the men and women at NASA who worked on the shuttle for the last three decades.
Absolutely fantastic. We are absolutely honored that you took the time to join the crew this morning and wake us up.
The spectacle of yesterday's 6-hour, 31-minute spacewalk by Mike Fossum and Ron Guerin has morphed into what essentially is a blue-collar day for the 10 crew members on board as we move into the heart of the mission and what this flight is really all about, and that is namely the transfer of almost a year's worth of supplies from Atlantis's cargo module, the Raffaello multipurpose logistics module that was attached on Monday to the Earth-facing port of the Harmony module of the International Space Station through the use of the station's robotic arm.
Ron Guerin is continuing to work on the waste and hygiene compartment, which is the station's toilet. He is swapping out some air hoses and some other components of that particular device.
Hey, that's the great thing about space flight. You know, one day you're doing the most outrageous thing humans have ever done, you know, spacewalking. The next day you're fixing toilets and packing boxes.
This is Michael Stipe from REM. We wish you much success on your mission and thank all the women and men at NASA who have worked on shuttle for 3 decades. From Earth, a very good morning to you.
As you can see, a variety of crew members gathering down in the middeck of Atlantis to prepare a variety of cuisine that constitutes the All-American meal that you've been hearing about. This All-American meal, again, was conceived in honor of this final shuttle mission of Atlantis and prepared by the Food Lab folks here at the Johnson Space Center. The crew's All-American menu, beginning with crackers, brie cheese, and sausage. The main course featuring grilled chicken, southwestern corn, and baked beans. And the pièce de resistance will be apple pie for dessert. The station crew will also have barbecued brisket as its entree.
I'm telling you, I've done a lot of these interviews, well, a few of them from space. The technology now is amazing. The picture, guys, you look like you're in a studio, maybe in Omaha, Nebraska or something. The shot is so clear. Is this a hoax? Are you really in space still?
See the hair?
I don't know. We're going to have to do something for you.
Yeah. Oh, I want to do it.
I know.
Oh, yeah, I can do that. Watch this. Can everybody float around for us? That was really cool, Chris. Can everybody float around? Look at her.
That is so cool.
Look at her.
That is so cool.
I think Sandy's hair is pretty much a dead giveaway.
It is.
Well, there you go. There's a pose for you right there.
Good day, sunshine.
Good morning, guys. Wake up. And good luck on this, your last mission. Well done.
Good morning, Houston, and thank you for that message. People all around the world love Paul McCartney's music, and boy, he can rest assured that people all above the Earth still love his music, too.
Atlantis ISS, please stand by for the White House.
Hello.
Hello, this is the International Space Station.
Well, this is President Obama. Who am I talking to?
Hello, Mr. President. You're talking to the Increment 28 crew and the crew of the Space Shuttle Atlantis.
Well, that's funny, see, because I was just dialing out for pizza, and I didn't expect to end up in space.
Well, yes, sir. It's really an honor and a privilege that you took some time out of your busy day to meet with us.
Well, listen, it is wonderful to talk to you. And I appreciate you guys taking out the time from your mission. I always want to just let everybody know how personally proud I am of you and the amazing feats you guys are accomplishing in space. And I was here in the Oval Office watching you guys take off last Friday. We're all watching as the 10 of you work together as a team to conduct spacewalks and manage experiments and do all the things that are necessary to keep the space station humming. Your example, I think, means so much, not to just to your fellow Americans, but also to your fellow citizens on Earth. And the space program has always embodied our sense of adventure and exploration and courage as you guys work in a really harsh environment. And I know that there have been thousands who've poured their hearts and souls into America's space shuttle program over the last 3 decades that are following this journey with special interest. And to them and all the men and women of NASA, I want to say thank you. You helped our country lead the space age, and you continue to inspire us. And Captain Ferguson, I realize that you're a veteran of previous flights, but It must be pretty special to be the commander on the last flight of the historic shuttle program.
Oh, absolutely, Mr. President. And just let me say, on behalf of all of the international partners aboard the International Space Station right now, we're all just absolutely honored and privileged to represent our home countries in this multinational effort. And to answer your question, sir, yes, it is an extreme pleasure to be just a part of this fine crew of four who will represent our country on the final space shuttle mission scheduled for an undocking here in just a few days and a landing at Kennedy Space Center in a little less than a week.
Good morning to the Stennis Space Center. Thank you for that lovely greeting. Houston on Air Ground 2 for transfer.
Good evening, Sandy. Go ahead for transfer.
Okay, per all these call downs, I show everything complete in the MPLM, and it's actually chock full. The ISPs have foam on them. All the end cones are full of foam. There's random foam in the ISRs that they came up with, so we're full.
Hats off to you and your crew. You guys have done an outstanding job. Of course, there's a little bit left to do for tomorrow, but that's nothing compared to the job you guys have already done.
Well, it definitely was challenging, but everybody pitched in, and of course, as I mentioned it before, we had a good plan. You guys did a lot of great groundwork getting us set, and if you guys would have done such a good job, and the folks at KSC getting stuff packed and keeping track of all the small things, it would have been a nightmare for us, but it really did go smoothly for all that we were working really hard, and we can't even tell you how much we appreciate all the work you guys did on the ground planning this out.
Well, I can honestly say we enjoyed it in some weird way.
Totally understand.
Johnson Space Center, our home with some of the hardest working, most talented people who have made some incredible things happen in spaceflight. We thank you for that greeting, and we're looking forward to another great day in space.
Hey, Houston, we've gathered everybody here at the Node 2 forward hatch. We have a couple different things we'd like to do today. The first of which is a special presentation, and that presentation is a special flag. That flag was handed to me personally just a few days before launch, and the crew of STS-135, the final shuttle mission, brought it to the International Space Station. And since we've been here, we've prominently displayed the flag on the forward flight deck. We actually had it there a little bit earlier on for a public affairs event, but Doug and I, Rex and Sandy, we just really liked it. It symbolized what we were all here for, and we left it there permanently, and I think it made us feel good. But we have that flag, and that flag is significant not only because we brought it up on this flight, but because it also flew on STS-1. This flag represents not just a symbol of our national pride and honor, but in this particular case, it represents a goal. This flag also will be flown prominently here by the forward hatch of Node 2 to be returned to Earth once again by an astronaut that launches on a U.S. vehicle, hopefully in just a few years.
Atlantis Station, Mike on the big loop. Station is ready for undocking.
Atlantis copies. Physical separation, Houston.
Houston copies.
Undocking confirmed at 1:28 a.m. Central Time. Atlantis weighs anchor from the International Space Station for the last time. 12.5 years of shuttle missions to build and service a million-pound complex at an end.
Atlantis departing the International Space Station
for the last time. Thank you for your 12 dock missions to the ISS and for capping off 37 space shuttle missions to construct a orbiting research facility. We'll miss you guys. Godspeed. Soft landing, and we'll see you back on Earth in the fall.
Hey, thanks, Ron, USOS lead, and to the station commander, Andrei Borisenko. We appreciate your hospitality again. Hey, when a generation accomplishes a great thing, it's got a right to stand back and for just a moment admire and take pride in its work. From our unique vantage point right here perched above the Earth, we can see the International Space Station is a wonderful accomplishment. It was born at the end of the Cold War. It's enabled many nations to speak one in space. As the ISS now enters the era of utilization, we'll never forget the role the space shuttle played in its creation. Like a proud parent, we anticipate great things to follow from the men and women who build, operate, and live there. From this unique vantage point, we can see a great thing has been accomplished. Farewell, ISS. Make us proud.
A few minutes after Atlantis reaches the point 600 feet directly in front of the station, the International Space Station will begin a yaw maneuver of 90 degrees under the control of Russian segment thrusters. That yaw maneuver will occur while Atlantis is in a period of about 27 minutes of station keeping directly in front of the complex. Once the station has yawed to the proper orientation, Doug Hurley will begin a 600-foot radial fly-around of a half lap around the complex, while Magnus and Walheim use digital cameras with high-powered lenses to snap away, collecting imagery of the longitudinal axis of the station, its modules, and its components.
And Station Atlantis, you'll be happy to know you look just as good from the side as you do from the front.
Thanks, Bergie. Not sure how to answer that one, but thanks.
Almost directly above the International Space Station, you can see the varying views, the solar rays that are angled through the beta gimbal assemblies to optimize solar array absorption of sunlight to be converted into electricity. On the far right of the axis of the space station, that is the Harmony module in the horizontal position. Basically, as you look at this view, that's where Atlantis was docked to. And on either side, those two large modules at the bottom is the European Space Agency's Columbus Laboratory. And on the top of Harmony, as you look at this view from directly above the space station, is the large Japanese segment of the complex, the Kibo module, and its external experiment platform.
And ISS Atlantis on the big loop, we're essentially complete with our fly around. We'll be coming out underneath you and should have a good view from the cupola. I'm not sure when we're going to break down the big loop, but if it's anytime soon, we just wanted to give you a final goodbye.
Hey, thanks, Fergie. We'll be watching you from the SM windows, and you guys look really good on the fly around from what we can see. And again, thank you so much for all that you guys have done for us up here. We really, really appreciate it.
Hey, Fergie, from the ULF-7 Orbit 1 team in the ISS Mission Control Room here in Houston, we just want to let you know that it's been our pleasure and honor to support this, the 37th mission of the Space Shuttle to the ISS. And we're proud to be the last in a countless line of Mission Control teams that have had the honor to watch over the ISS while Discovery and Endeavour and Atlantis have visited over the last 13 years. From this room, we've watched and supported as the shuttle has enabled the station to grow from a humble single module that was grappled by the shuttle's arm to a stunning facility that is so large that some astronauts have even momentarily gotten lost in it. You can take it from me. So, of course, the ISS wouldn't be here without the space shuttle, so while we have the communication link up for the last time, we wanted to say thank you and farewell to the magnificent machines that delivered, assembled, and staffed our world-class laboratory in space. So Fergie, Chunky, Sandy, and Rex, get her home safely and enjoy the last couple days in Space Shuttle Atlantis.
And to the great folks at the Kennedy Space Center who have cared for these vehicles for the last 30 years, a special good morning to you.
Chris Ferguson, commander of the final mission of the 30-year space shuttle history, I want to ask you, what do you see as the future of the American space program?
Well, we were discussing this just the other day. You know, it may seem like a sort of an ending, and I suppose to a degree it is. You know, the space shuttle's been with us. It's been the heart and the soul of the human spaceflight program for about 30 years, and, you know, it's a little sad to see it go away. But, you know, we have to understand these systems to operate and maintain are extraordinarily costly, and in order to go beyond, because, of course, the shuttle can only stay in low Earth orbit. In order to go beyond low Earth orbit again, we're going to have to pause. And we're going to have to stand down, and we're going to have to channel some of those resources that we use to fund and operate the space shuttle so we can build another vehicle. And we're going to go beyond again someday. Hopefully it's in the not-too-far-distant future. And we'll turn over this low-Earth orbit business, this space station servicing business, to commercial companies. But hopefully in the not-too-distant future, you're going to see a heavy-lift vehicle manufactured and by our commercial partners, designed by NASA in partnership. And we're going to go back to the moon, back to Mars. So the future is very bright. But at the moment, it's a little somber because we are saying goodbye to an old friend.
Sandy, if I could just pose this last question to you. What's your message to all those people, the thousands of people over the years that have been such an instrumental part of the shuttle program as you now say goodbye to this program after 30 years?
Well, you know, really the heart and soul of the space program is the people that work in the space program. It's a group of people unlike any other field, I guess, because everyone's so passionate and so dedicated. They work so hard, they take it to heart. And it's true of all the people that I've met in the United States who work in various aspects of the space program. It's also true of the people who I've met in other countries through my work with the International Space Station. I mean, there is a huge number of people worldwide who passionately believe in space flight and who dedicate their lives to it. And it's because of these people that the shuttle program was so successful for the last 30 years, and we were able to do the amazing things that we were able to do. And it's because of these people that the International Space Station has been so successful and will continue to be successful. And this same group of people will carry forward the momentum and eventually get us out of low Earth orbit to these other destinations that Rex was talking about earlier.
Fergie, it's time for us to bid you good night. I think I speak for everyone in the room when I say we all feel very privileged to have been a part of the 135 team with you. Also, speaking for everyone really in the space shuttle program, that we're so proud of how you've represented us really to the whole world on this final shuttle mission. Your professionalism and excellence have been really the best kind of tribute to the space shuttle and the many people who are part of its history. So we'll bid you good night, safe travels, and we'll see you back in Houston for the celebration.
Well, Megan, thank you. That was really very kind of you. Hey, you know, 42 years ago today, Neil Armstrong walked on the moon. And I consider myself fortunate that I was there to actually remember the event. I think that there's probably a lot of folks in that room who didn't have that a privilege or honor, and I can only hope that that day will come for them someday. It's kind of interesting to be here on the final night of a shuttle mission. Don't quite know what to think. We're just trying to take it all in. I saw a quote that I thought was really good, and it's very appropriate on this, the 42nd anniversary of the United States' presence on the moon, and that's that I pray that our nation will someday find the courage to accept the risk and challenges to finish the work that we started. I bid a farewell to the Orbit 2 team. I don't think we're supposed to see you tomorrow. I hope you don't. And let's just plan on this being our final shift. And when you go out the door, like I said, to Orbit 1, you know, take a look back at the mission control room and make a memory. Good night from Atlantis.
America, my
morning, Atlantis. And the wake-up music this morning was for the entire crew, and it was also for all the men and women who have put their heart and soul into the shuttle program for all of these years.
Hey, thanks, Shannon. What a classic patriotic song. So appropriate for what will likely be the shuttle's final day in orbit. And thank you, America, for supporting this program. And we'll see you on the ground here in a few short hours, hopefully.
Atlantis Houston, everything is looking fantastic. Therefore, you are go for the deorbit burn, and you can maneuver on time.
Hey, great news, Butch. Thanks. Go for the deorbit burn, maneuver on time.
Now looking over the shoulder of pilot Doug Hurley on the flight deck of Atlantis, this pilot point of view camera, Atlantis soon will be going subsonic. Our first view through infrared cameras at the Kennedy Space Center. Commander Chris Ferguson now flying Atlantis. Piercing the pre-dawn skies, the space shuttle announces its arrival at the launch site with its signature sound of twin sonic booms having gone subsonic for the last time.
Hey, field inside Houston.
Copy, Atlantis. Field inside.
The pre-flare maneuver executed. Landing gear down and locked. Main gear touchdown. Hurley now deploying the drag chute. Ferguson rotating the nose gear down to the deck. Nose gear touchdown. Having fired the imagination of a generation, a ship like no other, its place in history secured, the space shuttle pulls into port for the last time, its voyage at an end.
Your will stop, and we'll take this opportunity to congratulate you, Atlantis, as well as the thousands of passionate individuals across this great spacefaring nation who truly empowered this incredible spacecraft, which for three decades has inspired millions around the globe. Job well done, America.
Hey, thanks, Butch. Great words. You know, the space shuttle's changed the way we view the world, and it's changed the way we view our universe. There's a lot of emotion today, but one thing's indisputable. America's not going to stop exploring. Thank you, Columbia, Challenger, Discovery, Endeavor, and our ship Atlantis. Thank you for protecting us and bringing this program to such a fitting end. God bless all of you. God bless the United States of America.
And the commander is now leaving the crew transport vehicle along with our other astronauts. Being greeted by our NASA Administrator and our Center Director, Bob Cabana.
You know, it's a great day to be here and to welcome the STS-134 crew back home. I personally want to salute them and everybody who's been involved in this program. It's been a 30-year journey that has been absolutely incredible. And I want to say that all of us stand on the shoulders of some pretty giants. None any better than this. They have come to be known as the Final Four, and they did an absolutely incredible job. If you had an opportunity to watch any time during the mission, they were like racehorses the whole time. So they made us very proud. You know, we've been exploring since early in our country's history, and what Fergie and his crew did this time was kind of close out this era of our exploration. But I want everybody who was involved in this to feel incredibly proud of what you did and what your role was. Like me, they got an opportunity to do the flying, but we owe an incredible debt of gratitude to the thousands, literally tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of folk around the country who made all this possible. I had a chance to talk to some of you this morning, and you know, we were lining up the convoy. I thank you again for everything that you've done. The things that we've done have set us up for exploration of the future, but I don't want to talk about that right now. I just want to salute this crew, welcome them home, let them know how much we're, how proud we are of them. And Fergie, I ask you to come on up and talk for your crew there. So thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, Charlie. We really appreciate those remarks. I'll tell you what, you know, flying in space is a real dream, but flying in space, it has a lot more to do with who you do it with than what you do. And these three folks, Rex and Sandy and Doug, I'll tell you, if a commander couldn't ask for three better people to go and perform an aggressive and to a certain extent, you know, historic mission. I mean, there's no doubt that there was a lot of attention paid to this mission because it does bring to a final close 30 years of space shuttle history. I'm going to speak on behalf of them and just say that we're all, the three of us or four of us, we're honored to be a part of this. But ultimately, it's everyone who's worked on the shuttle program. Although we got to take the ride, we sure hope that everybody who has ever worked or touched or looked at or envied or admired a space shuttle was able to take just a little part of the journey with us. We're going to put Atlantis in a museum now, along with the other three orbiters, for generations that will come after us to admire and appreciate. And hopefully, I want that picture of a young 6-year-old boy looking up at a space shuttle in a museum and say, you know, Daddy, I want to do something like that when I grow up. Or I want our country to do fantastic things like this for the continued future. And if we set those steps right now and they continue with that next generation of space explorers, then I consider our job here complete. So again, on behalf of the crew, thank you so much for the time and the attention. And for the folks at KSC, thank you for this fantastic vehicle. It performed absolutely wonderfully. Not a glitch, and it's just as pristine as it was, I hope, on the day that we took it, barring maybe a door to the WCS, which opened up a little bit on entry. But everything is wonderful, the vehicle is great, and thank you very much.
Excuse us.